Today, you'll learn exactly how to increase your guitar speed. So if you felt stuck when trying to increase or improve your speed on the guitar, this is the lesson for you. I'm going to show you how to break through your own guitar speed barriers and limitations. So if your guitar speed has been stuck on a plateau, this video will help you move past it. Hi, I'm Tom Hess. When I was first learning how to build speed on the guitar, I got to a point where I could not get beyond. I had reached a guitar speed plateau, and I had remained stuck there for a really long time. I just couldn't break through that speed barrier. What I eventually discovered was that the problem was not in my hands, it was in my brain. After teaching guitar over many, many years, I've seen this exact same problem in all kinds of students. Now, since then, I've helped thousands of students online from around the world to break through their own guitar speed limitations. Here's a preview of what I'll cover in this guitar speed lesson video. First, I'll show you why many people hit a wall and struggle to break through their own speed limitations on guitar. Second, I'll show you what causes these problems and how those barriers limit your ability to play guitar really fast. And third, I'll show you the three levels of tension that you need to know about and then use when you practice guitar when trying to increase your guitar speed. And then I'll teach you a simple but very powerful way to practice guitar to build more speed in just a few minutes. You learn all of this in three proven steps. So let's get started. What you'll see next is an excerpt of a lesson I taught at a recent live HessFest event. Why don't you show me what you've got in terms of the speed that you're looking to increase?
Okay.
So what is the hardest part of that? If you had to pick one spot that was the most difficult or one aspect of that, what would it be?
Right now, in this particular example, it was, I think, two hands synchronization because there were some sloppy notes.
Okay. Do you feel that if this, which of the two hands do you think is more developed, the left hand or the right hand?
I have no idea. I can guess that the right hand is more developed.
Okay. Here. So let's talk about the left hand. What if we just covered the guitar, put our hand over the frets, don't push down, we're not going to fret them now. We're just going to touch. We're just going to pretend that we're playing. And we're going to try and use as light of a touch as possible. If you push down, then you push down, then you're using too much pressure. We're just touching the strings. Okay? How relaxed can you do that without fretting the notes? Is your left hand more relaxed now than when you were playing it before?
Yes, I guess. I cannot tell for sure. I didn't pay attention to it, but yeah, for sure it is. Because the movement is...
Smaller?
Smaller, yeah.
Yeah, smaller. And you're intentionally not applying so much force or tension, downward pressure, right? So everything is very loose. And the more you get loose at this, the easier it is to have the fingers move, and they don't feel restricted. You're not having to overcome movement going the other way when you're trying to relax and release, okay? So what I want you to do is play it three ways. The first way is without pushing down at all, okay? Then the second way is legato, where you're not legato. You're just actually going to push down. Mm-hmm. So now I'm actually fretting the notes with the left hand, not picking anything. It's not legato. I'm just pretending as if I'm playing as if I was picking. Okay? But I'm not picking anything. So this is not the same as doing hammer-ons and pull-offs. Okay? There's no hammer-on or pull-off motion here. And then I want you to do it with legato. Actually legato. Okay? So first, just touching the notes. not pushing anything down. Do that real quick. Okay. Do it fast, lighter, but faster. And this is going to train your left hand to not use so much force all the time, to release some of that tension so that it is more available to move faster, okay? Now, fret the notes, but no legato, no hammer-ons or pull-offs. You're just fretting them as if you were picking, but you're not going to pick anything.
Okay, but like this?
Yeah. Same thing with legato now. Now actually do the hammer-ons and pull-offs. No. Just cover the strings. So now you're doing the hammer-ons and pull-off motions.
I'm fretting.
Okay, do hammer-ons and pull-offs. Pretend
okay.
That your guitar is turned on and your right hand is not covering the strings and you're actually doing hammer-ons and pull-offs. So there's going to be three levels of tension here, right? Very light tension when you're only touching, right? Your hand has the most freedom to move. And then, same thing, but now you're actually fretting the notes, not just touching them, but it's not legato yet. Okay, so now there's a little bit more tension, a little more effort, tension required. And then with hammer-ons and pull-offs, there's a bit more. Okay, if we sit here and do hammer-ons, if you did this all day, the more tired you get, the more tension you're going to start to use, okay? So as you practice, tension starts building more and more and more, and you get fatigued more and more and more, okay? So in order to stop that from happening, we're going to alternate between actually fretting all the notes using the regular tension that you would normally do and just touching them. Okay. There's no secret magic to just touching the notes. This doesn't make you any faster. It doesn't make you any more accurate. What it does is it trains your brain to stop using so much motion. It reminds you, this is what it feels like when I am totally relaxed. Because your brain needs to remember, this is what it's supposed to feel like. It's not supposed to feel like this, which is what happens when you do a lot of legato practice. Okay, now you were picking earlier, so you're not going to be using the same amount of force when picking as you would when doing legato. But if you pick hard, sometimes the tendency is that you start getting tense up here, and that starts, it's like putting your foot on the brake. It starts slowing you down some. So all we're trying to do is remind the brain what it's like to play really light. Okay, and then we go back to playing it the normal way. Then you start picking. Okay, then we go back to remembering, okay, this is what I want it to feel like. So when I grab the pick and I start playing this, I want to get closer to this feel, okay? Try it. Go ahead and do it the light touch real quick, and then go ahead and pick it like normal. Now, go ahead and play it normal. Remember what it felt like to be relaxed. Remember that feeling. Do it again and try and keep that relaxed feeling in the left hand. Does it feel any different now than before?
Yeah,
it does. Okay, so that's going to help you. That's going to help you with the left hand. It doesn't address the right hand yet, but as far as the left hand goes, that's a way to get your brain to remember, I only need to press down lightly. I want to play light here, okay? So you just touch, then you fret, then you do legato, all covered, okay? Then you go back to picking, and then just touching. Then picking, touching to remind yourself.
Okay, there are similar exercises you can do also with the right hand to kind of, to get all of this to relax too. Okay, so if you just covered the notes and you picked the pattern and you didn't care about accuracy, you didn't care about synchronization, and you just try and pick real light, don't dig the pick down in here deep, and you just try and keep this relaxed, and then you go and pick it, this will start to show you what it feels like when you play relaxed, so you don't start digging in totally. Digging in is really good for some things. It helps you get a good articulation, it gives you more power, but you also have to be careful that it doesn't slow you down. So let's develop the speed and articulation. We don't want to lose the articulation, but we want to get the speed up first, and then we bring some of that articulation back in. Does that make sense?
Yes.
All right. Very good. Cool. Thanks, Peter.
Thank you.
So remember, most guitar speed limitations are caused in our brains, not in our hands. As you practice the concepts you learned in this guitar speed lesson, keep these things in mind. You're training your brain to remember what it feels like to play correctly without excessive tension and to play with a relaxed fretting hand. Practice your licks or techniques in the cycle I taught in this video. First, by just touching the strings, then fretting the notes without picking and without using any hammer-ons or pull-offs. Next, play them with a pick. And then repeat this cycle so that your brain is constantly reminded of what it should feel like when you play relaxed and without excess tension. Let me know in the comments which other kinds of topics you would like me to make new videos on. If you like this video, subscribe to this channel and hit that like button. If you want to double your guitar speed while cutting your practice time in half, I'll show you how in my free guide titled Double Your Guitar Speed While Cutting Your Practice Time in Half. It's totally free. Click on the link below to download your copy so that you can increase your speed on the guitar.